Last Saturday was February 22nd, 2020. Now, what's so special about this date? It was the 1 year anniversary of Anthem. Surprised? Me too. On the day, the game's various social media accounts didn't bother mentioning it. The website? Not a word. There wasn't even an in-game event until earlier this morning when they revealed anniversary celebration skins. After 7 years in development and hundreds of millions of dollars, BioWare's brand new franchise has its first birthday in fairly unceremonious fashion. At this point, Anthem feels like a distant memory. It's like waking up from a dream, trying to recall what happened, and all you can remember is, I think I could fly? But hey, some dreams are best left forgotten. Because Anthem's launch?
If you've got only $60 to spend in the next 3 months, I would not buy Anthem.
And what's wrong with Anthem is baked so deep into its crust that whole components of the game's mechanics and engine would need to be ripped out and replaced in order to fix them.
How do you make a game about jetpack-wielding super mecha suits boring? Well, BioWare managed it.
I wanted this game to be great, but it just isn't.
Despite its terrible launch, lack of interesting content, too many loading screens, and just overall poor design of the game, BioWare hasn't given up on Anthem. In fact, they have big plans. Those plans being Anthem 2.0, Anthem Next, Anthem whatever the hell they end up calling it, a revamp, an overhaul, another shot to get it right. That is what they're planning for Anthem. Now, rumors of Anthem 2.0 first popped up last fall, Jason Schreier posted an article in November citing sources who were working on the game, stating that while details were still in flux and there was no clear timeline, it was going to happen. Anthem would be getting major changes to its loot, quest, social elements, difficulty, progression, mission structure, the world, basically everything. Evidently, this all started happening just a few months after launch, when it was blatantly clear BioWare's new franchise was a flop, and simply adding more content to the existing game wasn't going to cut it. Something more drastic needed to take place. One of the sources said, "We spent a few months just tearing it down and figuring out what needed to change fundamentally, which was a lot, and we've been rebuilding for another few months since." But at this point, these were all just rumors. Nothing official had been announced. And outside of the company, to us the players, it seemed like BioWare had straight up abandoned the game, missing major content drops from their roadmap, and indefinitely postponing updates to focus on core issues. The base game wasn't great, nothing new was coming, and on top of that, several well-known BioWare employees left the company. Overall, things weren't looking good for the future of Anthem. That was until a couple of weeks ago, when Casey Hudson posted an official update announcing a revamp to the game. After some platitudes about how proud he is of his team for launching Anthem and how grateful they are to the community, he says, "Over the coming months, we will be focusing on a longer-term redesign of the experience, specifically working to reinvent the core gameplay loop with clear goals, motivating challenges, and progression with meaningful rewards, while preserving the fun of flying and fighting in a vast science fantasy setting. And to do that properly, we'll be doing something we'd like to have done more of the first time around, giving a focused team the time to test and iterate, focusing on gameplay first." So basically, he's saying, hey, the game that we launched isn't great, we should have taken more time to test it, I'm so sorry, let us do it over. He goes on to say that the current version of Anthem will go into maintenance mode as they put all effort into the next version of Anthem, apologizing for missing the mark and thanking the community for the feedback and support. And lastly, he says, "I look forward to working together with your involvement and feedback towards the best possible future for Anthem," which really could have saved the game the first time around. Like, had there actually been a full-blown beta giving people full access to try out the game, I think it wouldn't have taken very long for people to realize that what Anthem was fundamentally when it launched just wasn't going to be enough, and they could have fixed this stuff prior to the game launching. Now, some of you may recall, at some point last year, there was an article going into the development history of Anthem, which painted just a pretty terrible picture. Basically, over the course of 7 years, there were various times where the game got completely scrapped and remade, and it was only actually a couple of years before launch where they finally settled on what the final version of Anthem was going to be. And a lot of major features, including the flying, were a relatively last-minute addition. So I guess with that understanding in mind, it's not too surprising that Anthem came out the way that it did. How could they not have realized, like, as it was coming closer to launch, that the game just wasn't going to be enough. I really honestly feel if they had like a proper beta testing period, the players could have told them, like, guys, this isn't gonna cut it. And I know not every game like puts out these betas where people get full access to the game. I feel like these like live service games, these loot games, it's probably a good idea to give your player base a good indication of what the final product's gonna be, because otherwise you might get caught by surprise. I can't imagine they were surprised. Maybe they assumed that the negative reception wouldn't have been as bad as it was, and that they could have continued to update it and made it better, but as it was when this game came out, it was just a complete travesty. I still, though, have always thought that Anthem had potential. You know, prior to the launch with all the sneak peeks that we got, I was very hopeful that we could be looking at the next big open world loot game. Very early on, I did have concerns about just some of the general design, and even when I got an early hands-on impression, when I went out to EA Studio to check out the game, even at that point, I was like, there's some real big red flags here, but we still don't know how much what we're seeing is what the final product is going to be. And it turns out that was basically it. And all of the concerns that I had early on basically came to fruition. I'm not saying that I have all the answers when it comes to game development and figuring out what a good game is, but I could say if you had a lot of people trying the game early in its entirety, they could have pointed you to the fact that what you had there wasn't enough. But regardless, I still think the bones and the concept of Anthem is a solid one. And I'm glad that they're giving it another go. Like, I'm glad they're gonna take a second crack at Anthem, that we're gonna get Anthem Next at some point. They'll give this franchise another shot. Really, I think they have to. Even when I say that, I realize, why am I wasting my time? Like, honestly, what am I doing here? Why am I looking forward to a bad game potentially getting better instead of just focusing on good games that already exist? There are countless games out there that I've still yet to touch that I know are fantastic and I would really enjoy spending my time with. I suppose in general, I just like looking forward to good new experiences. And while there are still a lot of games out there that I could be spending my time with, there's a lot of great loot games if we're just even focused on simply this genre. There's a lot of great loot games that I could spend more time with. You know, everyone likes the idea of a redemption story, I suppose. Well, not everybody. There's a large camp that says, I don't care how good they make Anthem Next or Anthem 2.0, I'm not gonna give them any more attention because they don't deserve it, because they let us down the first time around. Yeah, I totally get that. I totally understand, and I think that's a fair position. I think when it comes to my personal perspective, I just always wanna try new games, and I wanna try new games that hopefully end up being good. Even though we know Anthem isn't good, there is a chance that Anthem Next could be good. The question is going to be how they present it. In that Jason Schreier article from last fall, there was still some uncertainty about how they're going to roll it out. Like, will it be a series of small updates? Is it going to be one major overhaul? Is it going to be a separate product that they relaunch? And if so, are they going to charge for it? I think if they go that route, it's not going to work out so well for them. But I think if they release this free major update, they call it Anthem Next or whatever the hell they want to call it, that would probably be the smartest bet. It should be a free update for everyone who owns the game. And if people want to buy into Anthem for the first time around, I think it should be reduced price. Like, I even if they do a complete total overhaul, I really don't think there's enough good justification for them to charge like a full $60 price for this game, which sounds kind of weird, but it's going to be quite a predicament that they find themselves in. At the very least, anyone who purchased Anthem has to get whatever new thing that they do with Anthem for free. It has to happen. And I also think that there is some hope, because, you know, we've seen this before. Some major examples would be like Final Fantasy 14, No Man's Sky, to some degree Diablo 3. These are games that launched, didn't have a great reception, but over time got significantly better to the point where they're actually considered pretty darn good games. Final Fantasy 14 in particular is considered one of the best MMOs out there at the moment. Diablo 3 is considered overall a fairly good ARPG. No Man's Sky, you know, people, it's still considered a good game. I just haven't been able to personally sink back into it. And I think really probably the biggest thing of all when it comes to Anthem Next, or just the Anthem as a franchise, they have to redeem themselves here if they have any hope with Dragon Age 4. BioWare in recent memory has just not been doing a good job with their games. There's been a lot of debacles between the Mass Effect franchise, most recently, of course, Anthem. BioWare just publicly hasn't been in the best spot in recent memory, and I think if they want Dragon Age 4 to do good, they have to get out from under the shadow of Anthem. And I think it has to be more than just bare minimum. They can't continue to have Anthem limp around on life support into their next next major release. They really need Anthem to be a strong showing. I think especially after a lot of the disappointment that people have had with the Mass Effect franchise, they can't have two major disappointments and then hope to sell people on their next game. And then also, I just think for the sake of Anthem, as a franchise, as an IP, I don't think they should give up on Anthem, because I think there is the nugget of something good there. An open world loot game where you fly around in these Iron Man mecha suits and just blow up monstrous enemies, and like, in the idea, there's so much potential. And BioWare is a studio that could deliver on this concept. It's just their initial go-around just... It just wasn't good. So I hope them going back to the drawing board and all of this really ends up delivering a solid product, because what Anthem is right now, the franchise could basically die, but I don't want them to give up on it, because I think it really could be something special. But we'll have to wait and see. So Anthem Next, it is coming. Hopefully it's good. Who knows?